Please go down the way you can enter if you wish to go through that door or that door, if you wish to step out. In the event you are fired, please exit through that door or that door there with the exit sign marked above. There are several scenes in this play which include acts of violence. Some of these acts include gunshots, bomb sounds in the distance, a severed head, references to rape, torture, and murder, and a scene with self-harm and suicide. So because we want to ensure that everyone is able to care for themselves, we can that scene-by-scene breakdown that you can receive in your programs so that you can anticipate the action before it happens. Please take this moment to silence your cell phones and any other electronic devices that you may have. Thank you so much for coming to the show. It's sure to be a magical time.
Damn. you're this far from home, you know you're never getting back.
This really his gun?
Yes, it was his gun. Who else has a gold-plated gun?
Damn.
Look at this poor bastard. He's hungry. You hungry, buddy? Hey, buddy!
Yeah, fuck you too.
God damn. You hear that growl, baby? He's starving.
How do you know for sure? How do you know that this was Saddam's kid's gun?
He raided the mansion. I was there, man, 2 days standoff.
Fuck.
What if my kid had gotten hit? What if... Kaboom. There's a big gaping hole in my cage. What do I do then?
What mansion?
The Hussein brothers' mansion, jackass. Uday and Hussein. They were shacked with gold and shit. Everything in that house was made of gold, practically.
Maybe I'd step out for a bit. Hunt something. Kill all the people. Kill everyone. Eat them.
What else was gold?
All their guns. Sergeant got the gold Uzi.
Then I'd sleep a little. Then I'd wake up. Kill some of the animals. Eat them. But I guess then I'd probably step out into the world. Not like the lions did, but still, I have to admit I'm curious.
The toilet was gold.
No shit! The shitter?
The world is probably a fascinating place.
The toilet was gold. Sergeant dismantled the whole thing. I want a seat out from the cover.
You want a toilet seat?
Gold toilet seat. It was a gold toilet seat.
Where is it?
Somewhere safe. I buried it.
Where?
Yeah, like I'm going to tell you, Kev. I'm going to tell you. Somewhere safe. Between this gun and that toilet seat, I'm set. Back home, I'll be sitting pretty.
Super pretty on a gold toilet seat.
No, man, I'm not going to use it. I'm going to hit eBay with that shit, you know?
Man, I haven't seen nothing since I've been here.
Sue is hell. Ask any animal. Rather be shot up and eaten than stuck in the fucking zoo 10,000 miles from where you're supposed to be. Like that polar bear they brought in 6 years ago. He committed suicide. Some world.
Hey, you got to kill Saddam's kids, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, that's cool.
And the fucking lions. They get it all, right? Every captive animal's dream that a bolt of lightning comes down and zap, frees you in an instant. There it was, freedom. And they blew it. They walked straight into the mouth of the beast. Those sons of bitches. It's too iffy strutting out into the world like that. I can see them now. All eight Leos running through the streets of Baghdad, laughing their heads off. And then, kaboom, mowed down by artillery. Casualties. A pride of fucking lions.
Man, I mean, I haven't seen shit since I've been here. Nothing. Now what a racket did I get to kill? And I ain't got my dick wet either. You know? Back in Vietnam, there were so many Vietnamese bitches all over the place, and everybody got these.
You weren't even born yet.
I'm just saying, there ain't much pussy in a Muslim country.
Sergeant gets some. Sergeant gets that shit all the time.
You ever get me a Iraqi pussy?
No, man, fuck that. I got values. Hand me that Slim Jim. Some bastard's so hungry, you don't even know he's hungry.
Leave him alone, he's barely got me furloughed anyhow.
Eat! Eat it up, man.
Don't want to eat.
Come on, tough guy, give me another crumb.
Leave me alone.
Attaboy! Get angry, eat something.
This is what I'm talking about, pure stupidity. I'm a fucking tiger.
Eat! Oh, my hand!
Yeah, your hand.
I was always gonna die here.
I guess that was my fate from the start. would have one good day. A day like the Leo's had. A brief foray out into the great wide open. I am bigger than them. I am bigger than those motherfuckers. So that's what I look like. You go your whole life never knowing how you look, and then there you are. You get hungry, you get stupid, you get shot, and die. And you get this brief glimpse at how you look to those around you, to the world. And it's never what you thought. And then it's over. Curtains. Kaboom.
Fucking business, I said.
Are you new?
I'm not new.
No.
No, I've seen action, boy.
Yeah,
but I have a gun. And you, if you knew, you'd talk.
I help you do your job.
I don't leave a shit for me.
I see.
That's why I get this badass equipment here, see? And that's why you get a fucking laptop. I can boot up and watch Fast and Furious, but I live it, bitch. I live Fast and Furious.
Why am I a bitch?
Shut up.
What kind of action have you seen?
What kind?
Yes.
I killed a tiger.
You killed
a tiger?
A tiger.
At the zoo.
Why?
Because he attacked my friend. He just bit his hand off. This guy, Tom, he's like my best friend over there. And so I shot the bastard in the gut. The tiger, I mean. He died. I saved Tommy's life, you know? Now he's back in America, and everyone's all, stupid fucking retard killing tigers and shit. Like, I did something wrong. You know, I wanted to take the tiger and skin him. I wanted to get a carpet out of him. They wouldn't let me. Can you believe that?
Yes. You got gypped.
Yeah, that's right. I got fucking gypped.
Gypped. That is one of the fragile phrases I learned.
Hey, you want to see something?
Yes.
Can't tell anyone you saw this, okay?
Okay.
I mean, I'm serious.
Yes.
See this shit right here? This was Saddam's kid's gun.
What?
Saddam's kid. I don't know. Last name Hussein. No touching, Habib.
May I?
I said no touching.
I would just like to, please? May I hold it?
Okay. But don't get any ideas, Habib. I will waste you. I was at the standoff in the palace. Maybe 2 day standoff. We killed those sons of bitches. Both of them. Man, that palace they had? Gold out the ass, man. Gold everywhere. I mean, their weapons were gold. Even their toilet seat was gold, boy. God damn. Dude, Habib.
You killed them?
Who?
Uday Hussein. Hussein Hussein. You're among the soldiers who killed them?
Yeah, dude, what? Okay. Oh my god, Hussein, you're jumping on me now. Okay. Habib, give me the gun, okay? Habib, come on. Come on, give me the fucking gun! Jesus! What the fuck is your problem, man? Are you going crazy on me? Do I need to shoot you?
You don't need to shoot me.
Good man, I don't want to shoot you. And what the fuck is your problem, though?
I don't have a problem.
Oh no, then what was that shit about, huh? Let's shake it around and shoot. Jesus. I mean, everything I see every fucking day is just whack, you know? I never see anything I've ever seen before. It's all just one crazy fucking thing after the other. You're a freak, Habib. You're freaky deaky, no shit.
I don't have a problem. Please leave me alone. Please leave me. Why are you here?
Because I gotta get dressed.
Go dress somewhere else.
You know what? I gotta be alone when I put this stuff on, or I don't do it right, okay? Doesn't mean I'm a fucking idiot. I just need to concentrate. This is like 50 pounds of gear, man, okay? It's Kevlar and shit. It's complicated.
Complicated?
Yeah, complicated. It's war, you know? Everything's all fucked up. Now I know how to go and put this shit on. I'm gonna go out tonight, and I'm gonna figure some shit out, okay?
I suppose so.
Catch you later, Habib. High five, man. Come on, man, high five.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Bitch. Talking about!
I need you down on the ground! Down on the ground!
Butania!
Butania!
What the fuck did she say?
Butania! Butania! been better to have died young. I'm an old ghost. There's a gang of teenage rhesus monkeys down at the zoo who got blown up by an IED. And they're carrying on like a bunch of morons, milking the afterlife for all it's worth. Want my advice? Die young. Die with your friends. It's the way to go. I mean, what the fuck is this supposed to be? Animals made out of plants? Vegetative beasts? I've been walking around this city for days now, and nothing has been very much of a surprise until I've wandered into this garden here. I mean, who does this? People. First, they throw all the animals in a zoo, and then they carve up the bushes to make it look like we never left. Insult to injury. Insult to injury. I don't know why I'm so scared. I think getting killed might be the last bad thing that can happen. The worst thing. I'll tell you right now, it is not the worst thing. See, all my life I've been plagued, as most tigers are, by this existential quandary. Why am I here? But now, I'm dead. I'm a ghost. And it's... why aren't I gone? I figured everything just ended. I figured the Leos just ended. Suicidal polar bear, bones and dust. It's alarming, this life after death. Fact is, tigers are atheists, all of us. Unabashed, heaven and hell, those are just metaphorical constructs designed to represent hungry and not hungry. Which is to say, why am I still kicking around? Why me? Why here? It doesn't make sense. A dead cat consigned to this burning city doesn't seem just. Here I am, Dante and Hades, Bengal tiger in Baghdad. You didn't think I knew Dante, did you? Now that I'm dead, I'm having all sorts of revelations about the world and existence. Things just appear to me. Knowledge, the stuff of the universe, it just sort of floats into me. Or maybe I'm floating into it. It doesn't help. No matter how much I learn, I'm still stuck here. I just thought I'd be gone by now. Why aren't I gone? Will someone please tell me why I'm not gone from here? Hear that? That call for prayer? A constellation of minarets surrounds this garden, each one singing in a different key, calling out to God, voices intermingling in the air. When an atheist suddenly finds himself walking around after death, he's got some serious reevaluating to do. Listen, calling out to God in this mess. God. You believe it?
it out. My other hand.
Holy shit, man.
They do you right. I'm like RoboCop.
Why'd you come back?
Didn't want to go out like that. Besides, I had some stuff I needed to get.
Like a toilet seat?
Yeah, that's one thing. And my gun?
Let me see your hand.
Check it out.
Shit, man, this is badass.
Yeah.
You've had me here like a week now.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah, I was fucked up.
What happened?
So, I was out on a night break. I go around the back and book it upstairs. Then out of nowhere, this motherfucker just comes out from under the bed and clocks me in the face, you know? Then I'm out. And the next thing I know, I'm on my way here. I want to get back, you know? This is bullshit. They just keep telling me they're running tests, you know? They're always running tests.
Yeah.
How's America?
It was all right.
Get any Mickey D's?
Yeah, I got some right before I came back.
What'd you get?
Did I order?
Yeah, Mickey D's.
I don't know. Big Mac.
Big Mac combo?
Yeah, with the fries and coke.
I always get the chicken combo.
Yeah, that's good too.
What else do you do there?
I don't know. Got this.
Did you do what?
No, man.
You did it? You went all the way back to the States and you did it. Wait, did you even see any bitches when you were there?
Yeah, at the hospital. My nurse.
Ooh. You tapped that?
No, man.
You didn't tap that?
Oh, man, Jesus. I got surgery for my hand. I wasn't thinking about getting laid.
Wish I could get some pussy.
Yeah, sure.
You know that tiger?
Yeah.
I shot him with your golden gun.
Yeah, I know. I was there, remember?
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying.
You have it?
What?
The gun, you have it.
Not with me.
Not with you?
No, dude, I'm out on a fucking night raid, and then the next thing I know, I'm on my way here. It's not like I had time to pack, you know what I'm saying?
Where's the gun?
I don't know, man. It's somewhere safe.
Where?
Dude, where's your toilet seat?
None of your business, Kev. Where's my gun?
I saved your life, man, okay? I fucking saved your
life. I don't care what you did. Where's my gun?
It's in your mama's ass.
What?
I said that gun? It's shoved up your mother's ass. She put it there herself.
Kev, do you know that my mother's dead?
She is?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, man. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go off on moms. I'm just saying, you know, I thought you came here to visit me. We could talk and catch up.
The gun is mine. I want it back.
You have your toilet seat. It's gotta be worth way more.
We're not gonna argue about this.
You know what? Just be a decent fucking guy. Give it to me, okay? I killed a tiger with it.
Look at this. Look at this, motherfucker.
What the fuck is your problem?
I lost my hand. It's gone. Do you get that?
Yeah, I get it. I was there and I can see.
I was gonna go home and work for my uncle. Now what am I supposed to do? I lost my right hand.
Dude, that thing's top of the line. Like RoboCop.
No, I'm not. Stupid handicapped jerk. I didn't even get a purple heart.
That sucks.
Yeah, it sucks. So now I have some gold that I can get, so maybe I have a fucking livelihood when I get back.
A livelihood?
Yeah, that's like what your life is.
So what, your livelihood's gonna be having a gold toilet seat and a gold gun?
No.
Great, because that sounds like kind of a whack-ass livelihood if you ask me.
Just shut the fuck up about it.
You ever think about him?
Who?
The tiger.
He bit off my hand.
You ever seen him?
What?
Do you ever just see the tiger, like, hey?
The tiger?
Yeah, we're talking.
What are you talking about?
I'm asking you a question.
Yeah, what? What
no,
is your question?
I'm asking you.
What?
I'm asking you if you've ever seen the tiger around or anything.
The tiger is dead.
Well, the tiger's dead. I killed a fucking tiger. I'm asking you if you've ever seen him around, like his ghost.
No, Kev. I've never seen the tiger's ghost. I don't believe in ghosts. Especially, I don't believe in animal ghosts.
I'm gonna tell you something, man.
Jesus.
Please, can I just tell you something? You're the only person I can tell this stuff to.
I don't even really know you, man.
Please, can I just tell you something?
Fine.
You know, I'm just trying to tell you something.
I said fine, okay.
Something wax, but you kind of
will wax. You just tell me?
Fine! You know how I said I was out on that night, right?
Yeah. And then some dude came out from under the bed and whacked you upside the head. I know.
Right. So, I'm lying there, right? And the dude takes off. I'm alone in the bedroom.
Alone in the bedroom.
Right? And the ghost of the tiger walks
in. The ghost of the tiger?
Yeah, man, it was crazy. It wasn't like he was in real life. He was walking on his hind legs.
Oh, shit, his hind legs.
Yeah, and he could talk.
He could talk. What did he
I was freaking out.
And then what?
That's the thing. I don't remember much after that.
That's a pretty stupid fucking story.
Not listening to me.
What?
Well, I didn't finish yet.
Well, finish.
Well, I'm just trying to tell you the story
or I'm leaving.
You know what? Forget it.
Forget it. Oh, God, you are retarded. You know that? Where's my gun, Kev?
I thought you came here to see me.
Well, I did come here to see you. What am I, your mother?
Dude, my mom's dead.
No, she's not.
So?
Oh, my God. You've got to be the dumbest piece of shit in the entire fucking world.
Did you even get my letter?
Yeah, I got your letter.
I wrote you a fucking
letter. Yeah, I know. Thanks. Thanks for the letter you sent me.
Got it?
Yeah, I got it. Right after my first surgery.
Yeah. I'm good at writing letters and shit.
I didn't ask you to write me.
You didn't. I ain't a fat
man. I didn't say you were.
Dude, I wrote you a fucking letter, okay? I saw what happened to you. You didn't remember. Do you remember that tiger bite?
I remember now.
Well, fucking A! I don't exactly think that's, like, normal. You think you're boring shit. I'm just glad I got to feel that tired. I was glad I got to save your life, Tommy. That's what people do when they have a friend of shit.
Well, thanks.
I want you. Partners, now. You think you're bad at this, Tommy.
Do you know where you are, Kev?
Lord.
No, I'm here.
Hospital.
They think you're nuts.
I ain't nuts.
You weren't attacked by no Iraqi from under the bed either.
You weren't even there.
You're going crazy.
No, man, I'm cool.
Go horse into a little bit.
You're
fucked, man.
You don't exactly have the best bedside manner. You know what I'm talking about, Tommy?
They got you on suicide watch.
That's not true.
Yeah.
No bullshit, man. If they did, they wouldn't be leaving sharp objects around for me to find, you know? You know, they wouldn't be leaving sharp objects for me to find.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the tiger.
The tiger is dead.
No, he's not, Tommy. He's right here.
Where?
Right here in this fucking room. He hangs out here all the fucking time. Wait, Tommy, don't leave. You're my best friend.
I'm not your friend.
Yes, you are. You are, man, and I need you, okay? I'm so fucking scared. Everybody look at that stupid fucking tiger!
Well, that's your cycle problem, Kev, not mine. Now, I have some gold I need to get before I leave here. And if I don't get my gun back from you, I'm gonna kill you. Understand?
Shit, man!
Nice guy.
Shut up!
I just remembered something. 16 years ago, I killed two children, a little girl and a little boy. Brother and sister.
Fucking dead-ass ghost motherfucker! Are you just hanging around? Trying to make everybody think I'm some crazy piece of ass shit grunt?
This was back in the Sundaram in West Bengal. Home. The only place these crazy stripes actually camouflage me.
I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry I shot you!
I'm telling you, for the most part, I'm very shy. I like to sit back and wait for something to walk by so I can kill it and eat it. I'm a simple guy with simple tastes.
Oh, I wrote my brother about you. He said, you're just a figment of my imagination and shit. You're just one of those fucked up things about being in the war. So what's up now, bitch? You don't even fucking exist except for me.
Anyhow, the two kids had strayed away from their village. Girl was collecting wood or something. I watched them curve around a corner. I was absolutely still. The boy at one point looked directly at me into my eyes. But he didn't register the significance. He never did.
You know what, though? Fuck Tommy! My brother's 100 times better than Tommy. If I was on suicide watch, they wouldn't leave shit around for me to find, you know? They wouldn't leave shit like this around. You know, shit like this!
I was hungry. They were food.
If you don't get the fuck out of my head, bitch, I will kill us both! You'll think I won't do it. I killed you once. I'll kill you again!
What if it is? What if my every meal has been an act of cruelty? What if my very nature is in direct conflict with the moral code of the universe? That would make me a fairly damned individual. After all, lunch usually consists of the weak, the small, the crippled, because they're easier to kill.
You want my hand? You want to take my hand just like you did Tommy? After you said you leave me alone, just like you left Tommy alone!
Stop! I'm guilty. That's why I'm stuck here. I'm being punished. We think the 12 years in the zoo, never hunting, never killing, never breaking God's ridiculous law, you think I would have atoned for my tigerness. Maybe that's my way out of here. Assuming God exists and assuming this punishment has a reason, I have to atone. I need you to tell me, how do I do it?
You want my hand? You want to take my fucking hand so I can get to-
I don't want your hand, I want your help.
I can get a new one. Just like Tommy did, fucking RoboCop and everything. See? No, I can still do what I want. I can do whatever the fuck I want. No, no fabulous time, just...
Right off the one kid's hand, and I drive this one to suicide. I'm digging myself into one hell of a fucking hole.
Walking around.
crown of my head. That'd be funny. I find all this very funny, my steward. Funny, funny, funny. But people don't like me. They say I'm a bad man, evil, a torturer. They say I tortured people. Of course I fucking tortured people. When you have people who have wronged you, who have attempted to kill you or your brother or your father, or you have people who look lasciviously upon your sisters and your wife and your girlfriend, and these men have felt it in their hearts that they would kill you and would wipe everything that has become you off the face of the earth, let me tell you, my friend, you would torture them. You would tie them up. And you would beat the soles of their feet with wet bamboo until they couldn't walk. Then you'd laugh and break their ribs, and you'd pull out their teeth and their toenails and watch them try to run away again. This is better than any movie you've ever seen. And once they have tired this and have given themselves up to you, ready for death, then you deny them this death. And you bring them their women. And you have your way with them. Because to watch your wife get fucked by a man who is about to kill you, well, that is a piece of shit day you are having, my friend. And that is why you don't ever fuck with Uday Hussein. Knock, knock. Anyone home? I just told a very funny joke. And you don't laugh, and you don't speak to me, and you are very rude, Mansoor, very rude. But yeah, man, I'm dead. I get about 26 bullets from here to here. The Americans got me, me and Kusei. And then what do they do? These US fucking troops, what do? They come into my home and steal everything I have like common little thieves, like piranhas. I had piranhas, I would know. And it is these greedy, hungry little Americans who you work for. You work for them to kill us, to steal our oil, to fuck us in the ass, Mansoor.
No.
No?
I don't work for the Americans.
You can lie to me, Mansoor, but you cannot expect me to lap up your shit like the dogs you work for. You, Mansoor, a traitor in everyone's midst.
I'm a different person now.
No, you're not, piece of mother shit, you are the same. And you lie to me.
I do not lie.
You lie. Why do you lie to me? Are you thinking you can slip one past me? Who am I?
You're dead.
Good. Yes, I am dead. And yet, here I am, roaming around Baghdad. Uday Hussein will not go away once more. He is not so simply shot down by a bunch of teenage Ronald McDonalds who think they are the hot shit of 2003. Americans, always thinking that when things die, they go away. Smoke?
No, thank you.
It's a Cuban. Cubans. Fuck me, man. Fuck me in the ass. Breathe it in. Even a dead man loves a Cuban. I'm doing good things here, Mancho. My pure existence causes destruction. Everything going down in the streets, the war still being fought, what they call the insurrection. I am the insurrection, Mansoor. It is me. You're not impressed. What's wrong? You're not so upset about that little thing with your sister, are you? I bet you are. I bet you are angry every day. But you worked for me. So I have rights. So shut up! Yeah, okay. Baby. You can go and cry like a baby.
What do you want?
That is not the question, Mansoor. The question is, what do you want? You find yourself in a fucked up situation all of a sudden, my friend. This gun was a gift to me from a Saudi sheikh. I can't even remember his name. They're all faggots of Saudis, you know. He gave me this thing. It was the best thing I ever got. That's when I started having everything turned into gold. All my guns, my tools, my kitchenware, my bedpost, my toothbrush, even the toilet ziggy. Shitting on gold, man. That's the king's way I love you.
King Midas.
What? What did you say? You said King Midas, is that what you said? And then you say never mind because me, Uday Hussein.
than that dream.
I won't do anything for you.
But it's not for me. I'm here, but I don't need anything. I have you. I have Kuseye. I have Rach. Just as I always have. And I am never going to go again. Look at me! What are you going to do with your life? Where do you think you're going to find work as a gardener? There is nothing left to garden right now. You think the Americans are going to employ you forever? They're already retreating, and they're going to leave you here with nothing green and nothing to work with except a big pile of shit. All you have is me and your gun. Who's this, honey? He remembers you. Hadia. Do you know what was the thing about her that we loved? Mansoor, look at me. Do you know what was interesting about her? The way she quivered, Mansoor. She was like one of the sculptures you were doing in my garden. What did you call those animals you made, Mansoor? What is that called, Mansoor? You tell me, but I'm always forgetting.
Topiary.
I love this topiary. You're the real artist, you know that, Mansoor. What? What do you want? You brought her to my garden. You brought your little virgin sister to me. I take what's mine was. I take it. And you should have heard it. Such a small creature making such a great noise. What a mess that was, my man. Maybe someday you could make a topiary out of your sister. You could carve her out of the hedges, and she can quiver in the wind. You need to start working again, Mansoor. All of your animals have died.
What did you ever do? Nothing.
She tells me she's afraid. I tell her I am too. Which you'd think would be comforting given the circumstances, but somehow, being blown to bits and then coming face to face with the likes of me, well, the girl starts to cry. You know? Her one eye cries. And I'm like, don't cry, but she cries harder. And so I say, hey, do you want to see something? And she stops crying and she's like, what? And I say it's a, I tell her it's a garden. She looks at me as if to say, big fucking deal, like I haven't seen a garden before. I say, no, it's a special garden. And I don't know why I say this, but I tell her it's God's garden. I say it's God's garden. He likes gardens, see? He tests us in them. He tempts us in them. He builds them up and tears them apart. It's like a fucking hobby. And she's skeptical. I can see that, but I bring her here. And she sees all these plants, these animals. She's never seen anything like it. And I nailed it. She's not crying anymore. She's walking around the garden, pointing. An elephant, a swan, a cobra. Fucking kids, you know? And this whole time I'm talking out of my ass, this whole God's garden thing. Maybe she knows I'm bullshitting too. The girl's no dummy, even if she only does have half a brain. For a second, we both look up at these ruined shrubs and think, okay, man, you work in mysterious ways. We get it. And I feel this swell of hope. And then she turns to me and she's like, when will he get here? What? She's like, when will God get here? If this is his garden, he has to come to it. He has to tend to it. Look, the green is all burnt. This animal has lost its head. Well, what am I supposed to tell her? I'm asking you to tell me. Because if you don't, I'll have to watch her cry again. I'll have to sit here and watch as her little single eye fills up with tears. And then her brain will fill up as mine did, and she'll understand the universe. And then her spirit or her body or whatever you've left us with, it will go on to other things. And this moment, this fucking moment, when she appraises a ruined piece of beauty with her one good eye, this moment will become extinct. Just like fucking you. Is that what you want? Say something. This animal has lost her head. Speak through me, or through her, or through someone, but speak. God, speak.
I lost my
I'm not talking to you, shut up. 5 minutes.
My heart
and only partially sure that my whole radio cargo would be used. Things must have carried out. I never knew about this stuff before. Now I do. I'm starting to understand how things relate. I'm just saying, Tommy, think about the physiology of the wrist. I mean, we're put together so well, and that tiger took off your hand in 2 seconds with just his mouth. How strong his jaws must have been. How hungry he must have been. I mean, he just took it off and ate it. It's amazing how quickly you lose a part of yourself. I'm glad I met you. You're a true friend. Your friend.
I'm not your friend. Leave me alone. What the fuck, man?
I'm sorry about getting the fuck in here.
I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry I shouted. Will you tell her I'm sorry I shouted?
Who's the girl?
She's a girl.
I can see that. Who is she?
I just need you to translate.
You told me this
Never mind what I told you. Just translate.
Translate what?
Tell her I'm sorry I shouted.
Who are Mustahi Ada Seika? Take care of what? You told me we were conducting interviews.
Just translate.
To her? I'm sorry. I'm not that kind of translator.
What if I tell you RSL? I give you an order and you follow it, or they kick your ass to the curb and be to your fucking job. Vicky Fick.
Vicky Fick?
Yeah. Vicky Fick.
What are you talking about?
Vicky Fick, yeah.
So check it out. I've been whacking off since I was 11. Always with my right hand. Probably at least twice a day since I was 11, always with my right hand. That's a lot of whacking off. I didn't think about it. My name's Tom. Yeah, Vicky Vick. It's not the same with the left hand. I broke in my right hand after whacking it off every day. It was about the shape. It was familiar to me.
Vicky Vick, $20.
Tell her.
Tell her what?
What I just said. Top of the line. It's not that hard. All I need her to do is stand behind me and I can show her. I can show her what she needs to do. It's easier than fucking. It's easier than picky thick.
Is it good, Mom?
She knew.
Is it good, Mom?
What?
She says your hand is shiny?
Yeah, it's shiny.
If you can show her what to do, why do you need me here? I'm saying, you asked me to come to you, that it is very important, but it seems you don't need me really all that much. This is a crude act. It doesn't need to be explained.
I needed to explain it.
Do you have any aspirin?
What?
I have a headache. Do you have medicine?
No.
Is it more good than sure?
You know?
What?
You're pretty cool now, you know?
What now?
She wants to know if you can remove it, your hand.
What are you talking about?
She wants to know if you can remove your hand.
What the fuck?
If it is possible.
What? Can I take my hand off?
I'm just translating.
Well, I mean, I could, but I'm not gonna. Well, can you just tell her? hello? What?
She says your hand smells like milk.
It doesn't smell like milk.
She says it does.
It doesn't smell like milk.
It does smell.
What the fuck are you talking about? It doesn't smell like milk.
No, it's not that.
Then what?
Nothing. I asked her what her name is.
Her name? I don't want to know her name.
Okay, fine. She wouldn't tell me anyway.
What the fuck does it matter?
It doesn't matter. She reminds me of someone. She reminds me of someone I get.
Well, you remind me of her. So why don't you tell her what I want and then get the fuck out?
What are you trying to find? Go to the trick line.
She wants some water.
Wait, what the fuck are we doing here anyway?
What are you trying to find?
Fine, water. Smell this. Does it smell like that?
Not smell your hand, Johnny.
It doesn't smell like milk. Ficky Fick. Ficky Fick with the hand.
It's too bad to get off young and have the chick stand beside you and yank it, but
psychological.
Don't worry. One of these days you'll figure out how to rub one off, Southpaw.
Go away.
Dear Tommy, how are you? I'm fine.
I didn't kill you, okay? I didn't kill you. You offed yourself and I didn't have any fucking thing to do with it.
It's not about whacking off, Tommy. You're not confronting the issue here.
Shut up!
You feel complete without your hand. You feel like you're never going to be you again. So you think, whoa, I'll go back to Baghdad and get my guns and my gold, and then I can whack off again, but things don't work out like that. Look at me! I thought I'd be in heaven by now, but I'm not. I don't know where I am. It's just a reverberation of what I used to be.
It's like God's revenge, you know? He's got us chasing our own tails here.
I don't got a tail! Look, Tommy, I'm sorry I'm bothering you, but you're the only person who can hear me. Besides the tiger, he just keeps bothering me about epistemology and original sin, which is annoying as fuck.
At first, it's pretty cool. The limitless fruit of knowledge hanging low in your path, and you realize it's the only thing to eat around here.
I know I ignored you when I was alive, too. But you were cool, you know? Not like those other guys. You were my patron saint around here, Tommy. Until you were a total prick and walked out at me in the hospital. I needed you, you know? But you were all, oh no, Kim, that's your psycho problem.
I didn't know you were gonna kill yourself, okay? I'm sorry. Okay, I'm sorry.
What kind of twisted bastard creates a predator and then punishes him for prey?
I wish I hadn't done it. But it's over now. I'm fucked up with guilt. What do you want me to do about it?
Become something else. I renounce tigerhood. I renounce myself.
Well, we all have a psycho problem now, Tommy. Me, the tiger, and you. I'm gonna figure it out.
If this is God's garden, maybe I need to become like these plants, twisting and distorting my natural shape into something more pleasing to him.
He's haunting me, and I'm haunting you. There must be some sort of relational algebraic equation the three of us can factor into and solve our problem. You know, I mean, algebra was even invented here, you know? Right here in Baghdad, by this dude, Abu Jafar Muhammad and Musa. Can he speak? I know, right? I'm like a straight up brainiac in the afterlife.
You know what really bugs me? Where are the fucking Leos?
And algebra was derived from the Arabic algebra, which means a reunion of broken parts.
Why are they wandering around here, scared out of their stupid minds, contemplating their animal nature? Why is it always me? Why am I always alone every step of the way?
I'm not a bad person.
Neither was I. I'm a fucking saint. I feel like existence has been
wrong. We're all just refracted. Shit, suck up!
Alone.
We're broken, man. Okay? Me, the tiger, and you. It's like that night at the zoo. We all fell through a prism and each part of ourselves just separated. Does your hand still tickle? Does it still itch? It's a phantom limb, Tommy. Just because it's gone doesn't mean it's not there.
I'll become a plant then. I'll cut away the pieces of me that offend the cosmos. I'll escape my cruel nature. Cruelty echoes all around me, even in this ruined garden. So I wonder if there is any escape. I wonder if I am just an echo, repeating and repeating and repeating.
She was too young for you. The girl. She was too young for you.
What are you talking about? She was a prostitute.
She was too young.
I gave her money.
I'm telling you, she was too young.
It was a hand job.
Listen to me. Listen to
what?
Me. Listen to
what?
Me.
Why are you listening?
She was too young.
Fine. She was too young. Arrest me.
What the fuck are you still doing here? You like watching another shit?
You told me to be here. You told me we had official military business. Official business? Mickey Fick?
around.
Ah.
I knew your friend.
What friend?
The boy who lost his mind. He said you were like his brother. He told me all about you.
Wait. Wait, Abby.
What now?
You knew Kev?
Yes.
Were you with him on that night, right?
Yes.
All right, look. This is, I don't know if you know anything, but Kev, he had a gold gun. It was gold-plated semi-automatic pistol. And he lost it.
I remember a gold gun.
You do?
Not easy to forget.
Yeah, not that hard to remember. Do you have it?
Do I have a gold gun?
Yeah, do you? Because it's mine.
Remember he was handing out gold guns now?
No, it was personal.
It was your personal gold gun?
Yeah, it was.
You must be very rich.
I was until I lost my gun. Do you have it?
What if I did?
What if you did?
Then what?
Do you have it or not?
I do have that.
Well, Jesus, man, I mean, give it to me.
I'm sorry. Why would I give you the gold gun?
It's mine. Look, I'm not in the mood, okay? I've got a headache and I'm stressed out. Give me my gun. I'm serious. It's mine.
No, you're not serious.
I'm not?
You don't know what is serious. You have no investment in this gun outside the fact that it is gold. This gun has history, but you... You're looting, so you have something. Something to take home.
Well, I don't care about what you have to take home, Johnny.
What the fuck are you talking about?
What the fuck are you talking about, Johnny?
My name's not Johnny.
My name's not Habib.
What's your problem, man?
You don't listen.
You work for us. I could have you fired. How would you like that?
And what would you say to me? That I stole his gold gun pilfered from the Hussein's brother's stash? No, no. There are rules for you. For me? There are no rules. No rules, nothing. Anarchy? Yes. Rules? No.
So go fuck yourself, Johnny!
My English is getting better. Maybe I get a job at CNN.
You know what happens if they find a firearm on your person.
How stupid do you think I am? That I'm just going to give it back? No. We will work out a deal. You get me some things, I'll get you the gold gun.
Jesus. What do you want?
Do we have a deal?
What do you want? I'm not going to make a deal with you unless I know what you want.
But you're willing to negotiate.
I'm willing to kick your fucking head in, Abby. What the fuck do you want?
I want weapons.
You want weapons.
Guns, ammunition, and hand grenades. And then I will give you the gold gun.
Oh yeah, okay. Because I'm an arms dealer, Habib. I'll get you a bunch of fucking weapons. Who do you think I am?
You're Marine, and you're a thief.
Yeah, and I get you a bunch of weapons, then what? Next thing I know, you're blowing us all away? What am I, a jerk? You really think I'm going to give a bunch of guns and shit to a terrorist?
I am not a terrorist.
Yeah? Then what are you?
I'm a gardener.
Don't get metaphorical with me. You're all the fucking same.
No, no, you don't listen.
What?
I'm a gardener, do you understand? I'm not a terrorist or an arms dealer or translator or Turk. I'm a gardener.
Fine, you're a gardener. Where's my gun?
No, you don't understand.
What?
You don't understand! I'm an artist! I'm an artist!
Yeah, okay, you're an artist. Give me my gun.
And the weapons?
I'm not getting a bunch of fucking weapons of me.
Then you're not getting the gold gun. Capitalism, thank you. Now you want something for nothing?
What do you want with a bunch of fucking weapons anyway?
What do you think I have in my name? A stupid job with the U.S. military? And what about when you all leave? What will I have then? I have guns and weapons that I can sell because that is the only thing worth anything. Is that so crazy?
Yeah, it's crazy.
I'm tired. Do you understand? I'm tired of working for the wrong people. I always serve the tyrants. I'm tired of making the same mistakes over and over and over again. Not anymore. I'm tired of being made a fool. It's a simple deal. What you want and what I want. Isn't that how the world's supposed to work?
She wasn't that young.
Do we have a deal?
I left my bag here.
told them I was coming back. They told me they'd keep it. I'm back now, and I'm not coming back. Ask her where my fucking bag is to be, but we're going to have a problem.
Cheese.
What?
She doesn't know a bag. This whole place has been destroyed. She's living in the rubble. She doesn't have anything. She doesn't have your bag.
What now?
She wants to know what wants to
do. I want my fucking toilet seat! What? Where are you going?
We need to leave.
Fuck, man, I'm going nuts.
I swear to God.
We can leave when we get my toilet seat.
What toilet seat? We came out here for my weapons.
You seriously? You really think I came out here to give you a bunch of weapons? I needed a turp. I need my toilet seat.
So where are the weapons?
There are no weapons. Wake up!
You lied to me?
Hey, tell her to come back.
You lied to me.
So what?
You came out here for a toilet seat? Do you hear how you talk? Toilet seat, toilet seat? You want something to shit on?
Gold toilet seat. It was a gold toilet seat.
Gold toilet seat. Gold toilet seat.
Make sense now?
I follow you around, everywhere, like a dog. Ficky fake, the middle of the desert. So you can have sex. So you can get a toilet seat. So you can shit all over this place.
It's a job, Habib. Do your fucking job.
Yes, Johnny. A job. A job.
Check it out, man. My gun. You actually brought it with you. Holy shit.
Yes. Check me out.
Give it to me, Habib.
You want the gun, Johnny?
Give me the fucking gun.
You want the gun, but you lied to me. You want the gun. I want to leave.
Don't you point that at me.
Or what? What will you do to me now? What else can you do to me now?
I said we can leave when we get my...
Toilet seat! Toilet seat? You want your toilet seat. You want your gold gun. And fuck you and your gold and your goddamn bullshit all the time!
You shot me. You fucking shot me.
I'm so tired. I'm tired of everyone.
Stop it. Stop it. Please, God, stop it.
Don't you pray to God. Don't you pray to God, you piece of shit, man. No God is going to hear you. Not out here. Not anymore. No God. No God.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, okay? Please. I'm sorry. Habib? Habib, don't leave me here. Can you ask
sure she knows anyone around here. Can you do that, Kev? Please, I'm dying.
Sadiqi Bangus. Ibrahim Sadi. The attack of the Malay. She says she has a first aid kit.
She has first aid? She's a leper. She has first aid?
I don't know if that's what she said.
Well, fuck, man. Tell her to go get it. I'm not gonna die here. I'm not gonna die here. I'm gonna fucking fight through it, you know?
At least you got your toilet seat.
Fuck you, man. Oh God. Thank you. Thank you so much. I got shot in the stomach with a fucking you with a band-aid. Oh God, Kev, I'm gonna die. No, 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 no. I can't believe I'm gonna die here. Out in the middle of nowhere. I'm from Michigan. It's shaped like a mitten. I was never supposed to die here. What happens when you die?
You know when you've been drinking all night? And then you kind of just start to fade? And you can't keep your eyes open even when you're talking? That's how it goes, man. It's not too bad.
I don't want to die. Tell her. Tell her I don't want to die.
Who am I being moved? This means the Atiya. She says she has been decaying her whole life. Her name was Boom and Rumble. She says she was made of sand.
Can you ask her how long she's not had any hands? How long she's just had stumps?
You mean you should get savage to come today? Min Jan Fri Arbata Sina Athanati will go. We'll go Shweba Al Jan. Since she was 14, she said they just slowly fell off.
This is what you get now if you lose your hand. It's top of the line. It smells like milk. Don't leave me, Kev.
What a shame. Maku Allah. Al-Jannat wa jahannam. Al-Mawt Munshi. Al-Mawt Musala.
Like that are happening to Uday all the time. I'm not like you are. I'm not the kind of are translating, and another, you are shooting people because they annoy you.
That's not why I killed him.
Then why?
Not because of that.
Tell me. Tell me why. Uday wants to know. Why?
Because we were in the desert. And the sun was going down. And the sun was going down.
What?
The sun was going down.
The sun was going down? Holy shit, my man, that's your excuse? The sun? You know that happens every day, right? The sun goes down. Fuck me, even my father needed better reasons than that. I thought you were good, Mansoor, but this?
Take it back.
It's yours now. You've earned it.
I'll never use it again.
Come on, not even once.
Never!
Don't tell me you didn't like it. That's a little good, no? Killing the boy? Watching him die? When you realized that the bullet hit, that it caused pain, you felt relief. I know it, man. The pain went away.
Yes. The pain went away.
Good. You're beginning to learn about survival.
It brought him down to his knees.
Yeah, yeah.
He screamed. He prayed to God.
And you told him?
I told him not to pray to God. I told him no God would ever hear him.
Nice. Good line.
I stood above him and pressed a gun to his head.
But you let him live. Better he could suffer.
No. No more. No more.
Mansoor, you can't let go now. You have a taste for blood. You like it. You want it again and again and again. It's very rude, Mansoor. Very rude. Do you know what your problem is, Mansoor?
I don't have a problem.
Your problem is this. The best thing you've ever done in your entire life was only possible because of me. Without me, you're just a petty gardener. With Uday, on the other hand, you're the artist. Building Topia, doing these great things because I wanted them. Because I employed you. Because I provided you with thousands of gallons of water in the middle of the fucking desert.
This is my garden.
No, Mr. Fuckshit, this is Uday's garden. You think this place is yours? These animals are yours? Even your memory, it all belongs to Uday.
No, I can remember a life without you. I can remember my sister without you.
When the blades of your shears she burst like a grape. Ruined my suit. Oh, Hadia. Hadia! 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 Such a small creature making such a great noise. Good boy. You take this, Mansoor, and go out tomorrow and find someone else. It'll be easy. The sun will set, and then you'll have no choice but to kill somebody. No, Mansoor, someone else.
I won't be like you. I am myself. I am myself.
Can I look yet? Musa, can I look?
Not yet.
Don't bring her into this, Mansoor. You will not want to see this again.
I want to see your garden, Musa. Can I look?
I'll take her again. I'll do it all again. I will tear her to pieces again and again and again.
You can look, Padya, but then you have to leave. But for now, open your eyes.
It's beautiful, Musa. It's lovely. Look, a bear, a cobra, a swan. What's that?
You have to leave, never come back, leave now.
watching me and her? Me and her, me and her? Is that what you want to see? All right, watch. I'm going to take her back there and make her into a toolie. This time, I'm going to wear a bib. Oh, one more thing. That boy you killed, he was the boy who killed me. Thank you, Mansoor. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Watch.